an exquisite example of hematoid ferruginous hematite included quartz, a floater, so this would have formed maybe in a thick clay as is. The back section is almost going into a gray, where we have a clarity, you can actually see into these crystals. There may be some copper included in this as well. A similar material I got from Steinkopf not so long ago, this particular one we're just going to go with Orange River region, which would be in the Northern Cape of South Africa, where the Orange River meets the makes a border between South Africa and Namibia. On the South African side, roughly between Kakamas and Springbok, so that's quite a large section of country, a few hundred kilometers, but out of the mountains there, these guys hail lovely, lovely piece. And of course, minor specular hematite sitting on the quartz crystals. What we have here is quite typical to this deposit, which causes the phantoming as well. You have an initial generation of quartz and a secondary quartz flow which came over it. And on this initial generation, you have hematite, which as yet has not lost its oxygen, so it hasn't turned into goethite as yet, causing a lot of the redness often. From a display point of view, I would display it on a turntable going around like this. Of course, we want to focus on the main crystal here, cross like that. Lovely piece, almost a wing on top there. And let me see how close we can zoom into this. All the way from South Africa, hematoid ferruginous hematite included Orange River quartz.